Hello, wonderful person. This is Anton, and today we're going to be talking about our planet Earth and about trees. Because in this video, I'm joining the hashtag teamtrees. And my goal in this video is to show you something that China has been doing that we really need to consider doing as well. And for this reason, without further ado, let's talk about this and welcome to What the Math. Now, in case you decide to switch this video to something else, well, maybe first consider supporting teamtrees.org. This is a collaboration between thousands of YouTubers, and our goal is to literally try to plant 20 million trees by January of 2020. And since this is such a challenging goal, we're basically going to be asking these guys to help us. This is a charity whose only goal is to literally plant trees. For every dollar we donate, they're going to plant a tree. So we need to try to raise $20 million in a couple of months. And since so many different influencers are literally coming all together for this particular event, I'm actually excited to be part of this. Although, just like so many other influencers, I'm also going to be planting trees and possibly post it on Twitter or Instagram later on. But because I wanted to make this video educational and also interesting, I really wanted to talk about what China has been doing. And this is going to really blow your mind, because even though China has been getting a lot of negative press lately, there's one thing that they've been really kicking our butts in, and that's social engineering projects, specifically projects to improve nature and to improve environmental conditions. And although officially this started back in the 70s, it really didn't pick up until a decade or so ago. And here you can see the reasons why China decided to do all of this. This huge cloud you see that covers this really big part of China, this is pollution. The pollution in China became so insanely high and affected so many people that they really decided to kind of implement official policies to fight it. And one of those policies was literally planting more trees. Now, I actually made a video about all of this a few months ago, and you can check it out somewhere above my head. But in a nutshell, what NASA has discovered by looking at various maps of various parts of the world is that, for some reason, India and China have actually been turning more green over time. And with India, we realized that it was most likely due to various crop plantations. But with China, it was a very different story. It was actually forests. A lot of forests. Huge amounts of forests. And remember how I mentioned that as influencers, our goal is to try to plant 20 million trees in the next 2 months? Well, just to give you a comparison, our unofficial competitor China has actually been quite successful in planting about 12 to 13 billion trees per year. That's billion, that's not million. And for a very long time, just like NASA, I was actually kind of confused how they managed to pull it off, mostly because it's very, very difficult to get any kind of information out of China. Because unlike the US government, or really most of the other governments you can think of, China doesn't really like advertising things. They don't really tell us what's happening. So after relatively thorough research and actually visiting China a few times, I finally figured out what they did and how they did it. And there are three major things I wanted to mention in this video, and all of them are kind of cool. So first of all, when the pollution thing happened in China, it was for the most part in the so-called Hebei province. I'm sure I mispronounced this, but basically it's kind of right here, which is really ironic because living in South Korea, I'm often affected by this. A lot of the pollution from this province actually comes to the east of the country, and it does unfortunately hit Korea quite a lot, and we do experience a lot of pollution days because of the Chinese emissions. And although officially this is the image that Hebei province always had, and this is the image China was trying to create, the reality was a little bit different. There were a lot of factories, a lot of pollution, and a lot of this was basically creating a huge concern for the entire country. So to fight this, China did something that no one else could. They took all of the soldiers in the north and told them to go and plant trees. A lot of trees. Millions and millions of trees. You can read more about this in the article below, but this is essentially what NASA discovered as well. There was a sudden increase in the north part of China, where suddenly there was a lot of greenery everywhere. And even though this hasn't really stopped the pollution just yet, it has decreased it quite dramatically. But this didn't explain everything. There were a lot of other patches around China that also got green. And I needed to figure this out by doing a little bit more research, until China actually helped me a little bit. They released a video very recently promoting their successes across the so-called Inner Mongolia. This is the really green part you see right here. And in this video, they show us that they initiated an extremely large engineering project. It's bigger than anything anyone has ever done. And in this project, their goal is to turn desert into an actual forest. Now, there is a problem with this. One is that it's actually a little bit difficult to do this without affecting a lot of other things in the environment. But they're really actually trying this, and they've been partially successful. There are a lot of problems they have to solve, and there's actually quite a lot of things they have to overcome. But in the last few years, I've actually heard only good things. Although some people say that it's only the beginning, there are still maybe a lot of things that can go wrong, specifically because a lot of the trees that are being planted are going to decrease total amount of water in those areas. But nevertheless, this is an impressive project. So impressive, as a matter of fact, that I think I would like to go there in a few years just to see this for myself. But just this video alone kind of gives you an idea that something really crazy is happening there, and they've actually been able to, I guess you can call it, greenify a huge part of the desert. Now, compared to this project here, it's actually a huge undertaking. Not only because it requires a lot of manpower, but because it requires technology that is only being developed today. It's something that no one has ever tried or attempted on such huge scales. Because in order for trees to grow in a desert, you have to find a system or create a system where water can be delivered, and all of this has to function really well. You can check out this amazing video that Smithsonian made about all of this, it's also in the description below. Although before we go on, I have to also kind of warn you, you have to take all of this with a grain of salt. Remember, a lot of these videos are coming out of the Chinese government. These are not independent reports, reports created by independent journalists. Unfortunately, all of this is government, I guess you can call it propaganda. But in this case, at least one proof exists coming out of NASA. Because, as I mentioned before, we have seen the parts of China becoming more green over time. And interestingly, for the Inner Mongolia, the main part of this project is actually to stop the encroachment of desert. In other words, to stop the desert from growing. Their goal is to shrink it, and they've been quite successful. It apparently already has shrunk by several percent, and they even have a name for this program. And obviously, they decided to name this the Great Green Wall of China. And although there have been quite a lot of failures in this program, it has been overall quite successful to the point where China has even suggested that they're going to share all of this technology with the nearby Central Asian countries. In other words, they're actually going to be sharing this technology with pretty much everyone else living in the same desert. And even though some scientists suggested that because of the type of trees that have been planted, it might not really have a really long-term effect, or it might actually kind of retract again and turn into desert over time, right now, the Chinese deserts have been shrinking by about 2,400 square kilometers per year. That is a huge amount. Just to give a comparison, here's the map of the US with little squares, each of them representing roughly around 2,400 kilometers. And that's literally like turning each one of these squares into a forest every single year. And their eventual goal is to increase the total coverage of forest in China by about 35% in total. That's actually quite a lot considering the size of China. It's the third largest country in the world. But people being people, not everything is of course perfect. One thing I was able to discover is that in some parts of China, farmers came up with a very interesting scheme. They would actually cut down all of the existing trees just to plant new trees and get the government money or the government grant that's given for planting trees. In other words, they destroy the environment just to create a new environment that might not really survive. And so some of the scientists in China suggested that instead of trying to replant trees, maybe a better effort should be done to preserve what's already there and to encourage growth in the environment that already exists, which is not really done right now. At the same time, several studies, including this one that you can find in the description below, suggested that China is being way too aggressive about this, to the point where it's very likely going to dry out a lot of areas nearby and actually have a negative effect rather than having a positive effect. And this was actually published by Chinese researchers that suggested that this whole aggressive planting tree technique might end up warming up the planet and also dry out a lot of areas that would need this water otherwise. Which actually has already been suggested by some of the studies that discovered that even though China is losing its deserts, it's gaining a lot of semi-arid areas. Essentially areas that are a little bit drier than usual. But I guess only time will show us what's going to happen. But there's one more thing I wanted to talk about. Because China is also investing into something that I've never really seen before. Literally a city of trees. A tree city. A few years ago, someone in China decided to try to invite this Italian architect, I believe his name is Stefano Architetti, who created this beautiful apartment building somewhere in Italy that has quite a lot of greenery and a lot of trees on it. And the Chinese government gave him quite a lot of money to try to take this to the next level. And this is actually one place that I really want to visit. Sometime next year, in 2020, they're going to be opening this up. This is known as Lilja Forest City. And upon completion, it's going to house about 30,000 people, so it's not really a big city, but it's going to be totally self-sustainable, while at the same time being very environmentally friendly, producing absolutely no pollution, and actually even decreasing pollution over time in the areas nearby. Now, there are unfortunately no real photos from this location yet, and as a matter of fact, I don't believe anyone can even visit it yet, but I'm really excited to try going there once it opens up. The actual project and the entire concept behind it is absolutely brilliant. Now, whether it's going to work is of course another question. But if anyone can pull it off, it's going to be China, because it definitely takes a lot of central organization here to make this work. And hopefully sometime next year, I'll get to visit this place, take a lot of pictures, make a video, and possibly meet the residents. You never know. And if you want to learn more about this project, this is also in the description below. So when it comes to planting trees, China has definitely been kicking our butts. Which is why I'm super excited to be part of Team Trees and to try to encourage you to go to the website below and potentially donate something, anything, but better even, go out there, find a place to plant a tree and do so yourself. Because even though I guess it's great that we're supporting a charity, it's even more great to do so yourself and to put actual effort in preserving our nature, preserving the environment and making the future much better for our kids, our grandkids and everyone else after that. Now, unfortunately, even after this campaign, we're still going to be far, far behind what China has achieved. As a matter of fact, the amount of trees we're planting now or trying to plant now is only about 0.1% of the annual tree plantation in China. But if we can succeed this year, next year, let's take it to the next level and then another level. Let's basically show China how it's really done. Anyway, on that note, thank you for watching. Check out all of the links I mentioned in the description below, and I really highly encourage you to go and check out the charity we're supporting, while at the same time, maybe consider planting a tree out there. I'm gonna try to make a video sometime in the future where I do that myself as well. Unfortunately, it's getting really cold outside, so I couldn't really do it this week. But you know, my mom always told me, stop making excuses and go and make it work. Anyway, on that note, thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you still haven't. Share this with someone who... Actually, share this with everyone. You know what? Share this with absolutely everyone, because everyone needs to know about this. And come back tomorrow to learn something else. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Space out. And as always, bye-bye.